In this video, we're going to take a look at the routing section of all tracks in Live. All tracks in Live have a routing section. To access the routing section, click the button labeled I/O in Live's graphical interface, or use the shortcut Command-Option-I on a Mac or Control-Alt-I on Windows. The first chooser of the router section in a MIDI track allows you to select which device can be used for MIDI input. If all ends is selected, the MIDI track will respond to all MIDI input devices that are connected to Live. The second chooser allows you to select which MIDI channel the MIDI track should be set to. The monitor section is set to auto by default. When monitor is set to in, the MIDI track will only receive MIDI information from a MIDI input device that has been selected from the chooser above, but notes playing from the MIDI clip have been disabled. If I switch the monitor section back to auto, the MIDI clip will resume playing. When the monitor section is set to auto, monitoring is turned on when a track is armed and turned off to play clips. The chooser in the section Audio 2 allows me to select where the audio signal from the MIDI track should be routed to. By default, it's set to master, but you can also select the external output of your audio interface. And if it has multiple outputs, you can select which output it should be routed to. The audio output of the MIDI track will then bypass the master channel and be routed directly to the output of your audio interface. Now let's take a look at the routing section of an audio track. The first chooser under Audio From allows me to select which audio device or track the audio signal should come from. If external in is selected, the audio signal will be routed from my audio interface. With the second chooser, I can decide which audio inputs from a device or track should be selected. In the monitor section, the default is set to auto. If I set monitor to in, you can hear the incoming audio signal of that particular audio track without the track being armed. When monitoring is set to auto, monitoring is turned on when the track is armed and turned off to play clips. The Audio 2 chooser allows me to select where the audio from that particular audio track should be routed to. You can choose to route the audio signal to other tracks or to your audio interface. The second chooser allows you to select which outputs you'd like to use. When tracks have been grouped, the Audio 2 section will send the audio to the group track, which in turn will send the audio to the master channel. Group tracks also have a routing section, but this is limited only to an Audio 2 chooser, where you can choose where the audio from the group track should be sent to. In my audio track labeled resample, let's have a look again at the Audio From chooser. If I select resampling, I'm now able to resample the audio coming directly from the master track output. With resampling selected, I'll arm the track and record a clip. In the group track label Drum Group, I'll open the send label B to send the audio from the group track to a return track which has a delay device in it. In return tracks, there's also a routing section available. In this case, there's only an Audio 2 chooser. Here you can select where the audio signal of the return track should be routed to. By default, it's set to master, but in this case, I'd actually like to send it to an audio track, so that I can record the audio signal of the return track as a clip. Last of all, the master track also has a routing section. The chooser under Cue Out allows me to select which audio outputs of my audio interface I'd like to use. The chooser under Master Out also allows me to select which audio outputs of my audio interface I'd like to use.